Watch Charlie XCX laughs off major wardrobe malfunction. If one were to write a love story of Nick Jonas and Priyanka Chopra, it would go a little something like this. First came love after several years of friendship and one slightly embarrassing display of affection at an Oscars party, then came marriage. And then, just to really solidify things, a bunch of extra weddings thrown in for good measure. There was the initial three-day celebration, featuring a Hindu ceremony, a mehendi and a sangeet, which is pretty par for the course with any Indian wedding, plus a Christian vow exchange to recognize Jonas' faith. And then they had another reception in New Delhi, plus a couple in Mumbai, so Chopra could include her coterie of Bollywood friends and her parents' pals. Once back stateside, they held one for Jonas' family. And then, as these things tend to do when you're trying to please everyone even tangentially involved, it got to the point where the couple could do nothing but poke fun at their own revelry, with Jonas captioning a photo of them at a February 2019 charity gala, walking into wedding reception 100,047 like, haha, just kidding. Which, shrug, sure, it was a lot. And if one of our friends was asking us to fly somewhere and toast to them for the umpteenth time, we'd for sure be complaining behind their backs. But judging by the disparate guest lists, the round-the-world ceremonies were meant to cater to friend bases in different regions, so it was actually pretty thoughtful. And sometimes when you find that person you're meant to do life with, it's hard to stop celebrating, okay. By all accounts, the pair are still going, albeit without the bridesmaids and the grandiose floral arrangements. Every single day when I wake up I am like, oh, I have a home. Like, this is my home. This person is my home. Chopra, 39, shared with E! News ahead of their first anniversary in 2019. And I didn't know that feeling outside of my parents. Like, it's like, oh, this is the family that I have chose. It's family. And, yes, they have plans to expand that brood, answering in the affirmative each time they're asked about gracing the world with their offspring. She is the most important piece of the puzzle, and it's obviously something we hope happens, and God willing, it comes together, the 29-year-old Jonas brother told E! News earlier this year. You know, whatever is right. We're blessed to have each other and have a full heart for the future, I say, and things are out of your control. And the foundation of a couple is strong, and you're excited about the possibility of that. Regardless of how it might turn out, he continued, it's going to be a beautiful journey, and I hope for many, or whatever that is. Well, go figure that out when they get there, but for now it's just about making sure we're good. And until then, it's fun to look back at what would have been 2018's wedding of the year. You know, if not for Chopra's good buddy Meghan Markle, it's pretty tough to top a wedding at a literal castle, where we'd be hard-pressed to name the most famous guest because the list of attendees includes everyone from Oprah Winfrey to George Clooney to England's reigning monarch and the next, well, all of them basically in the line of succession. Save for then 1-month-old Prince Louis, who was tucked away far from the festivities. But boy did Jonas and Chopra swing for the fences. With some 225 guests, including older brothers Kevin Jonas and wife Danielle Jonas and Joe Jonas, with then-fiancé Sophie Turner, gathered in Jodhpur, India, the duo took over the Umaid Bhawan Palace at 347 rooms, one of the world's largest private residences, for 4 days. First, there was the November 30th mehendi, where both bride and groom were adorned in henna, and the sangeet, the traditional choreographed and costumed song and dance night, made all the more fabulous by the plethora of professional musicians in attendance. And the fact that, as Chopra revealed in her book Unfinished, she impaled her foot on a shard of wood mere hours before slipping on a pair of heels and dancing her heart out. I was like, no one is going to rain on this parade, she explained to E! News. Thus, the show went on, and what a performance it was, Chopra wrote on Instagram. Each family telling our stories to song and dance, filled with lots of laughter and love. We were both filled with a gratitude for the effort, the love and the laughter, and we'll carry the memories of this special evening for the rest of our lives. It is an amazing start to a lifetime of togetherness for our families and friends. That Saturday, December 1st, saw the couple officially joined by his ordained minister father, Kevin Jonas Sr., in a Western ceremony held on the palace's expansive lawn, the setup dripping in flowers. Chopra herself carried a bouquet of tuberoses, but nothing could distract from her resplendent 75-foot veil and hand-beaded embroidered Ralph Lauren gown, just the fourth bridal look the designer has ever created. It was a nod toward the 2017 Met Gala that initially brought the Ralph Lauren-clad pair together. It was all tears, she told People of the Moment. I could not hold it in. I think I was nervous and scared. But as soon as the curtains opened, and I saw his face, it was just like everything settled and I knew I was making the best decision of my life. Same for Jonas. You know, you think your whole life about that moment, he told the mag. Honestly, I could not have imagined it would be as perfect as it was. It was highly emotional. The following day didn't disappoint either, as the couple did a ceremony redux, the extraordinary displays of flowers now laced with pops of red to coordinate with the bride's traditional lehenga, and the end of the night fireworks displayed just as impressive. closing out the festivities of it a bridal ritual. That's all the actress family blessing her future with Jonas. I love that our wedding was a religious mashup, she told People. We took beautiful traditions that we both grew up with and personalized them in a way that made sense for us. It's been incredible to find the commonalities between our beliefs and figuring out how to blend them in a respectful and meaningful. The whole weekend planned by Sandeep Khosla and Aditya Motwani of Abu Yani Sandeep Khosla and Motwani Entertainment. Event Chopra had imagined and every bit as exhausting as she predicted. Joking ahead of time to Vogue, she said, people will need vacations after this. Still, as fantastical as it was far from too much, she reasoned during a January 2019 appearance on The Ellen DeGeneres Show. It was just 3 days. She protested when the host poked fun at their extravagance. One Indian ceremony and one Western Christian ceremony, and one day of pre-rituals, which we have in the Hindu wedding. But it was not like, usually Indian weddings are 1,000 people, at least. We only had 200, which was mostly family because both of us have giant families. So, actually, she reasoned, it was quite small, particularly when you consider the former Miss World as one of the country's biggest stars. My mother was so upset with me the whole time. She was like, I need to have another wedding for the other 150,000 people that I know. How can I not invite my jeweler? How can I not invite me hairdresser? So it was a whole conversation. One that no doubt ended with the compromise that unfolded. Rather than having one party for 1,000, they'd have five or so, playing host to several hundred. Each time, just 2 days after their Hindu ceremony, the couple traveled to Delhi for another grandiose reception at the Taj Palace Hotel. Their moods were very jubilant, a source told E! News of the time of the bride in a Falguni Shane Peacock Lehenga and her groom in a navy tux. She was happy in addressing everyone in the party. She and Jonas looks like they are on top of the world. They rode that wave to a Deck 19 party in Mumbai, where they shared their joy with her parents' friends. This has been an extremely special chapter in my life and I wanted my husband to meet all of the special people that have contributed to it, she explained of the never-ending celebration thanking her mom, Drive, Madhu Chopra for hosting and her late father who I know is here. And she couldn't resist spreading a little of that joy online, writing on Instagram, and the party don't stop. It didn't with another party the next night, reportedly for her Bollywood friends. Eventually their nuptials turned into a game of sorts, where in the world their Nick and Pree celebrating their marriage, and stretched on for so long that they had to take breaks in between, attending another wedding in Mumbai, celebrating the holidays with Turner's family in England, ringing in the New Year in Switzerland and even going on a Caribbean honeymoon before finally making their way back to the States to fete their union with his side of the family. At Nelly's Southern Kitchen in Belmont, NC, named for Jonas' late great-grandmother, Mama and Papa Jonas invited guests to come celebrate their boy and his bride, as a sign set up inside the January 27, 2019, event proclaimed Nick and Priyanka just got hitched, but that knot that they tied has not been dipped in. Grab your honey or hot chicken grease, so they appropriately dug into some home cooking and cake, introduced to the strains of Joe Cocker's You Are So. By this point, the constant clinking of glasses and first dances had become too much for even the groom. When asked by James Corden during a 2019 carpool karaoke session with his brothers if there was a moment that you thought, I am done with these weddings, Jonas responded, yes, it was when I looked at the still, he and Chopra have no regrets about how they marked the legal entwining of their lives, even if that means they have to suffer the occasional ribbing, both from strangers and those close to home. With his July 2019 wedding to Turner on the horizon, Corden asked Joe what tidbits had picked up from seeing his siblings get hitched. Mostly things not to do, the middle Joe bro joked. They were both absolutely beautiful. All 18 of Nick's were amazing. With Kevin, he continued, his winter vows occurred during a snowstorm, so maybe don't get married in December. And for Nick, there were quite a few, but I would say stick to one. One and done. Well, two, actually, he and Turner getting legally hitched in Las Vegas after the Billboard Music Awards before their French affair that summer. Remarking on the whirlwind that was getting engaged in July to locking in a venue in October, Chopra told Elle UK, we had 1.5 months to plan, so we're just like, yeah, let's get it, which makes the over-the-top nature even more impressive, TBH. It was very extravagant, she continued. Hopefully you just do it once. So it's fine, with just a few extra celebrations for good luck. A version of this story originally published on Deck 1, 2019 at 3 a.m. Pacific Time.